Stuart Nash, 5-minute call.
Thank you very much, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, if there's any doubt there's a little bit of dissension in the National Caucus, we just had to listen to Judith Collins. I mean, I don't know who sets the national speaking list. I suspect it might have been Jamie Lee Ross, but whoever put Judith Collins up to speak about trade obviously was up to set her up. Mr. Speaker, when Honourable Judith Collins stands up and says, don't trust anything that Labor, National, Greens do, well, I would say to Judith, I'd say to the people of New Zealand, when that minister starts speaking about trade and free and fair trade and good standards, we've got to be worried, because the one thing we know is when Judith Collins speaks about trade, it possibly means that any piece of legislation may lack transparency, accountability, and very definitely responsibility. But Mr. Speaker, that's true. What about Orofita? We're still murky about that. What the hell happened there? I don't know. No one knows. Mr. Key doesn't know. Only Judith Collins and the Chinese officials know. But Mr. Speaker, the former minister was right in one respect, when she said that we need excellent, robust standards that have international recognition. She's dead right. In fact, the role of the standards is, and let me quote, standards make an important contribution to the economic growth and health and safety. Standards promote innovation, facilitate international trade, and enable firms to leverage their competitive advantage. Many standards are also designed to increase safety and manage risk. And Mr. Speaker, that is why we have, on this side of the House, a real problem with the bill as it stands, because we do not think that this piece of legislation mirrors that in any way, shape or form. Now, Todd Miller must understand this. Todd Miller must have a huge problem with this. And I'll tell you why, Mr. Speaker, because Todd was at a senior level in a large organisation. And Todd Miller understands governance. He understands the need that governance is about managing risk and mitigating risk. That's what governance is about. But it's not just the reality, it's also the perception of risk, Mr. Speaker. And the fact that a large number of submitters highlighted the perceived conflicts of interest here is really telling. In fact, let me read out what one submitter said. And this is the Centre for Advanced Engineering. You could hardly say that this is a Labor Party organisation or anything like that at all. What they said is, and I quote, MB as the building regulator should not be in the business of drafting standards, many of which are building sector related. The relationships as set out in the bill between the Minister, the Standards Approval Board, the Standards Executive are awkward and unnatural and could easily lead to significant difficulties. The removal of personally interested people and parties from the standards processing setting is impractical. Mr. Speaker, the real concern I have about this, and I worked in international trade, I know how these things work, the real issue I have with this piece of legislation and the framework it's setting up is that the Ministry of Building Innovation and Employment, MBIE, will simply not get the buy-in necessary to give this new body credibility. And that is a real problem. James Shaw of the Green Party highlighted the fact that the Australian Standards Authority has massive problems with this legislation. And if we can't get on with our Australian brothers and sisters, let alone everyone else, if they are voicing such major discontentment with this piece of legislation, then it says something's wrong. Now, Mr. Speaker, it mightn't be there is. Maybe it's only their perception, and that isn't the reality. Whatever the issue, this legislation needs to change. It needs to go back to the Select Committee. It needs to go back to the Select Committee, and it needs to be changed, because the perception, Mr. Speaker, is this piece of legislation will not do the job that is required by New Zealand, by New Zealanders, and by our international trading partners. And, Mr. Speaker, that is why the Labor Party simply cannot support this bill. Thank you very much.